Hello and welcome to The Next Big Star. I'm your host, James Kelly, and my co-host is Ninon de Vera de Rosa.
Oh my goodness, James.
I was going to say it wrong, but anyway.
No, you didn't.
And then we have Sally Olson with us today, and we have Ned Mills, and we have DennisD'SatchmoKeating. Oh my gosh, I got everyone's name right. What happened?
You slept good last night, huh?
I guess so. All right. And Sally and Ned are with the Carpenters Tribute Show, and then Dennis, tell us what you do.
I do a tribute to the late, great Louis Armstrong, the father of jazz, born in 1901.
Wow. Yeah. I did not know that.
Long time ago.
All right. And we're on the show today. We're going to be talking about a show we're doing. It's called For Quirky Minds Media. We're actually producing a show, a fundraiser. I'll get this out in a minute. Yeah. And it's going to be for the performers of Las Vegas and mainly for the people who are out of work or struggling to find work. Because with the COVID-19 situation, most of these players, they lost their concerts. I think you, Sally and Ned, you lost one. You had 20 concerts,
I believe. Yeah, we had about 20 or so concerts scheduled for 2020. And one by one, they each got canceled and postponed.
Mm-hmm. And Dennis, how did that affect you?
I was doing 18 shows a month.
Oh, wow. So that's the reason for this fundraiser. It's going to be at Stoney's Rockin' Country on May 5th from 5 p.m. till 10 p.m. We're going to have raffles there. We're also going to have a silent auction the night of. And we have various performers. We have with us, we're going to have, you know most of these people, right, Sally?
Mm-hmm.
So who do we have here?
Well, let's see. We've got Gary Anthony, who does a wonderful Frank Sinatra tribute. Got John Anthony, who does Rod Stewart, and we have some great pop singers, including Chris Ivan and his partner and co-writer.
Yeah, he's the co-writer of the one, yeah.
Joe Lusion. Uh-huh. Who else?
Barbara Cartland. Barbara Brighton. She might be flattered that I called her Barbara Cartland, but Barbara Brighton.
Right, she does Joan Rivers, and then we've got Chad Collins, who does a Luke Bryan tribute.
All right, and we have Michelle Jones. She's a good friend of Ninon.
Yeah, she's coming from Orlando.
Right. And then we have Allison Ward. Mm-hmm. Allison does the ABBA tribute here in town, but she also does other things as well, but ABBA is her main thing. And then Luca Gazzera. And everybody knows Lou, I think. Yeah, we all know Lou.
American Idol finalist.
Yeah. Uh-huh. And then you have Ruthren Umali. Ruthren is new to the scene. She just produced her first album, along just like with Chris Ivan. And so they're going to kind of be doing their own.
Great performer.
Very good performer. And then Master of Ceremonies,
Robbie Howard.
Oh, that's right. Mm-hmm. Robbie Howard, yeah. Right. And he does impersonations.
He does about 100 different voices.
Yeah.
So Sinatra.
Comedian. And he's a crooner. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So. Oh, and then Kent Foote, variety singer.
That's right. Mm-hmm. From the
and then we have the who's the drummers we're going to have?
Oh, right. Korobo Taiko Drummers Group.
And then we also have Sally and Ned. Yep. For the Carpenters Tribute.
And we have food.
So it's going to be a great night.
And we have the red carpet.
Ninon's going to be doing the red carpet as people come in.
Yeah, I'm going to interview everybody that comes
in. Right. We're also going to have what's called a step and repeat.
Yes.
I'm learning what that means.
I know.
It's basically the panel where you can go, you get your picture taken. And
you get an interview. I interview you all and see what's going on. Absolutely.
We're also going to have a meet and greet after the show for anyone who does a sports sponsorship for us.
Yes.
You know, so you can go to All AspectsRadioNetwork.com and go to the events page, and you can see how you can be a corporate sponsor. But the general admission, you can go to our site and it will link into Stoney's, or you can go straight to Stoney's.com and go to the live event page or the live, what is that called, live music?
Their calendar of events page, yeah.
And then it'll show our fundraiser. Mm-hmm. Click on that and it'll give you all the information. And you can buy general admission tickets there. We do have a caterer who's going to be there. Food will be available. We're going to have it. Yeah, food and drinks. Now, drinks is through Stoney's. You just go to the bar there and order what you want. When it comes to the food, we're going to have the caterer there, and they're actually selling plates, which I will get on the website the next day or so, and you can buy those in advance, or it's like $15 in advance, $20 the night of. So you save money if you order in advance. So anyway, that's going to be a great little thing we're adding.
Mm-hmm.
So tell us a little bit about the Carpenters Tribute.
Okay, I'll start if you want me to.
Yeah,
okay.
Sure.
Yeah, so Ned and I have been performing together as Karen and Richard Carpenter for about 2.5 years, I would say. Mm-hmm. And I started performing as Karen Carpenter about 6 years ago in Vermont, which is where I'm from. And then 3 years ago, I moved to Las Vegas because I wanted to develop the show and I needed somebody to play Richard Carpenter. And I met Ned and he was interested in the project, and the rest is history. So we put together this new version of the show a couple years ago and debuted it 2 years ago this month. And now we also have a Carpenter's Christmas show. So it's the main show is a recreation of the Carpenters' 1976 UK touring show.
And that's with the authentic costumes and everything. I mean, you really duplicate or replicate that entire
yes, show. Yep. Yeah, absolutely. Yeah, right. It's scripted. And what we deliver as patter on stage is exactly what Karen and Richard would say.
That's so cool. Mm-hmm. Yeah, that is so cool. Yeah. And I've seen, you can go to YouTube and see parts of that show as well.
Yeah.
And boy, I encourage anyone to go there and really, you're going to love it so much, you'll want to buy a ticket. You'll want to be a corporate sponsor.
Absolutely.
And Dennis, I love the way you start your show, because there have been times when you started your show where you're behind a, well, I guess you'd say a sheet or something to where it's a silhouette.
The screen is a silhouette.
Yeah. Right. And the reason for that is that you sound like Louis Armstrong, but if anyone's watching this, they know that you don't look exactly like Louis Armstrong. And that's what's great about it, because when you come around the screen, they see a different person.
Correct. And I've been doing that for approximately 17 years, and it was trial and error. And now I've not only incorporated Louis Armstrong songs into my tribute, I've taken other artists, anyone from Neil Diamond, Barry Manilow, to Michael Bublé, and I'll sing in my voice and also as close to Lewis's voice as possible to let people know what Lewis might sound like today.
Yeah, that's fantastic. So it's going to be a great show.
It'll be a fabulous show. But your voice is amazing. Liz,
thank
Louis
you.
Armstrong voice.
You're too kind.
When you can't, when you don't see you and then you listen to this, it's just like him. I mean, it's amazing.
Yeah.
I often wonder, and also, you know, Sally.
Well, I remember the first time Sally was on this show, I listened to a little bit before we went on air, and
remember,
it really gives you cheer. It gives you chills. Yeah,
it
really
does. Yeah.
So, you know, that's incredible. Now, Ned, you've done other things as well. In fact, you do things all the time. You're not just with this tribute show.
I can't sit still.
No.
I can't keep a job. I just keep moving. No, I'm just kidding.
Keep singing.
Yeah. No, I came to Vegas actually next month, and in next month will be my 21st anniversary.
Oh, wow.
In Las Vegas. Before that, I was a music director for American Hawaii Cruise Lines, and tough job, you know, working everything. Yeah. And when I came to Vegas, I have my own show that I've been doing called Piano Follies. Basically, it's as myself, but it's almost like, I don't know, Liberace meets Victor Borge and shakes hands with Jerry Lee Lewis wrapped up in one show.
Nice.
And did that for a while and do a lot of conducting. I've had the honor of working with some Vegas legends, include the late, great Don Rickles, Joan Rivers, and done some conducting bands, orchestras, and so forth, and headlined some cruise ships for a while. And so now our focus right now is on taking the Carpenters tribute as far as we can.
Well, I'll tell you what, it's really a great show, and I can't
Thank
wait
you.
For people to see it. And that night, you know, Dennis, I know you're one of the invited performers, but originally this the idea came about because of Sally and Ned, so that's why they're headlining this whole event. But we are going to have performers starting, I believe, at 6, Ned, or 6:30.
6 o'clock.
Yeah. And
it
then
opens at 5, though.
Opens at 5,
it opens
yeah.
At 5
and
o'clock.
We'll have food ready to go at 5, so if you want to come in and have dinner.
To get yourself a table and seats and
sure.
everything else.
Sure, so. And eat yeah. before the show.
The taiko drummers are
The taiko drummers will be
the
going,
open,
right. Yeah. While you're there before, you know.
The silent auction, they can bid on.
We're going to start the silent auction as soon as you come in, so you can start bidding on items. Those items will be available on the website to look at.
And they can win a dream date with Ninon, too, I think, during
the Ninon oh, did not know that.
That sounds pretty cool, man.
Yeah.
Be careful, Sally, be careful. It's a dream date, right?
How many have I got? It'll be fun.
So it should be a really fun and exciting night.
Yeah.
We're looking forward to it. Anyone want to add anything?
Yeah.
You just got an idea, though. You can have a silent auction to have dinner with me.
Oh, there
yeah,
you go.
We're going to do
there
that. I
go.
Think we talked about one
idea.
More person. Mm-hmm. We might auction off another person
yeah,
or two
we
as well.
Yeah, we were talking about that. We
talked about a certain person. Yeah, that's
cool. Yeah, we may auction off Barbara.
Yeah. Oh, Barbara! Barbara! Oh, Barbara! Bright. Let me tell you, if you get a date with her for dinner, You have a fabulous evening. She sings, she's a comedian, and she never stops talking.
Right, so you don't even have to say anything.
She talks more than I talk, yeah. And I talk a lot.
So we'll auction both of you off.
Not at one time, no. She has her own dinner, and
Yeah. We're not talking about...
I love the woman.
It's not a double date.
But that would be a great thing. Yeah, you can auction me off.
If you want double dates, we'll make it a double date.
No, I can barely do one date, never mind doubles.
I would like to say that the show, the idea came about, like doing it for a charity, is the Composer Showcase of Las Vegas.
Yes, we need to mention them for sure. Right.
They do. They've been so kind to help out entertainers during the COVID crisis. They were giving out $500 grants to help out entertainers and stuff. And this is just a way of community giving back.
Ned and I were both lucky to be recipients of that grant. Of that. So
because they really have heard with the, because that's what Vegas is entertainers. That's all it is, but that's what.
But that, it's the main draw.
It carries it because.
Well, it's important to mention, too, that we have on Facebook, if you go to Aspects of Writing or All Aspects Radio Network or Quirky Minds Media, there's a link there for that fundraiser where we're actually asking donations to be given. And all that money will go to the Composer's Showcase of Las Vegas.
Yeah.
And then when it comes to our website, you can also go there and you can donate to what we're doing that night, which is putting performers to work.
Yeah.
So there's two ways to go there and donate. And that's important for people to know.
But also for the money from that, aren't we giving that also to the performers or try to help them out as well?
Right. We're going to be helping out performers with the funds that come in from that.
We're not saying, it could be $50, it could be $100. It depends how many people come. I mean, how many people does this place hold?
Right. That night, all the money raised for the fundraiser and for the fundraiser at Stoney's as well as the fundraiser on Facebook will go to performers.
Performers,
basically,
yes.
That's the way of putting it.
Yes.
So that's the best way of putting it.
Yeah, absolutely.
And considering Las Vegas is the entertainment capital of the world and how things, the entire world just shut down last year, I think it's a very important thing that we can do things that we can to try to get the entertainers back to get our livelihoods back as quickly as we can.
Absolutely. Right. Everybody knows it's a town square, right?
Yeah, Stoney's Town Square, Stoney's...
On Las Vegas Boulevard.
Stoney's at Town Square.
Las Vegas
It's very close to Fry's, where Fry's used to be.
Right.
So you just go past that, and you're toward the end of the backside of Town Square. You cannot miss Stoney's Rock and Country. It's a huge facility.
Yeah.
So, and great venue. And we are going to be having the silent auction there. There will be items there for the silent auction. So we'll have everything there to talk about. All the things for the silent auction will be available on our website to go and view. So please feel free to go there and take a look at everything that will be on that website.
Absolutely.
All right.
And of course, Sally and Ned, they've really given so much time here, and they put so much effort into this.
Yeah.
And not only for themselves, they've done this for the entertainment people out there. And I think, we need to sort of thank them so much for what they're doing.
Oh, thank you.
Other people as well, because that's what it's all about. It's helping other people at this particular time. But I have to say one thing. I was driving down yesterday the boulevard. It is opening up. Hey, guys out there, it is doing amazing. It is opening up.
Yeah.
I got first time ever I've been in a traffic jam, and I really liked it because it was Vegas Boulevard.
Hey, there's
and
life.
I love the traffic jam. I thought, I'll sit here for hours. I love it.
I saw on the news some footage of Fremont Street. It was on national news, packed. Packed with people.
Yes.
I'm like, thank you, God.
So we're all grateful for everybody coming in and really being they've been very, very nice, though. They seem to be bowing down to Vegas opening. It's cool.
Yeah.
So this is where we need all the entertainers, and we're not only helping the group we have here, we're helping other entertainers.
Absolutely.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, and we've had a couple of people coming in and out who's been handing us stuff, just so you know. So when you see a door open and stuff on the video portion, you'll know why.
Somebody was just crawling on the floor. You've got something there you have to show.
Yeah, we have a few things here that we're going to be showing.
I think it was Amazon. It just popped in.
Well, you're not going to see it on camera because of where I am. But we have an album here for Frank. We have one from the Carpenters.
And these are all things we're auctioning off, right?
Right.
These are for auction.
Yeah. And there's a ton of stuff on our website. So that you'll be able to see all this on
Sally
the website.
Has something too.
Sally has a t-shirt that they have for
we're
their thing.
Hold it up.
Yeah. I don't think we can see it because I'm not on camera.
Oh,
so
oh wait, I'll give it to Ned.
Oh, there we go. Put it up there. There we go.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Absolutely. Yeah. We just hot off the press.
Hot off, literally, hot off the press. So we're gonna have quite a few things, and you have some paintings.
I have a couple pieces of artwork
that you did.
Yeah, so I do.
And these are
carpenter's themed artwork. Mm. So this is one print here.
Wow.
And then another.
That's her limited edition. She studied art in
Paris, Notre Dame theme.
Yeah.
So.
That's fantastic. Yeah. So we're going to have quite a few things that we can put
quirky
up.
Quirky things from Quirky Media.
From Quirky Minds.
All kinds of quirky things.
Yeah. So,
and we might even have a dueling Louis at the end of the show.
Okay.
Because Ned does Louis Armstrong.
Yeah.
And we do have a special number at the end of the show, so we hope everyone sticks around for the very end of the show. We're not going to say what it is, but I think it's going to be a very special number that we're going to do at the very end.
If I can, because I have a little bit of a sore throat, but...
But in addition to that,
maybe that'll work to your benefit.
Yeah.
Dueling Louis, that's funny.
Ooh. All right. So, anyone have anything else to add?
I also would like to thank James Kelly. James Kelly is the owner of Quirky Minds Media.
Can you do me a favor? Your mic might have been. I hope it's on.
I hope it. Well, if it's not on, I'm just got a mouth moving.
Well, we'll pick you up on Dennis's mic, if nothing else.
Okay, so, doesn't matter. All right, okay. I just wanted to thank James Kelly. He's the owner of Quirky Minds Media. Absolutely amazing. Put a lot of time into this as well. So.
All right. Well, thank you very much.
Absolutely.
Thank you.
And then we publicize it today on Ninon, Vegas Live with Ninon as well.
Yes.
It's all over the place. I've got it on every single media thing I have. So we're out to help the entertainers of Las Vegas, okay?
All right. Well, thank you, everyone, for being on the show today.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
All right. Thanks. See you at the event May 5th.
Absolutely.
All right. Thank you.